prior to join us, Encik Salim spent more than 15 years in property. Start with Guthrie, then after that SMW, and the last is PNB. Then he left St. John in 1986 as a two-year Kuala University. They were probably SPM.
Yeah.
Then after that, he did his degree in real estate in UiTM. After that, he pursued Harvard Business School. Then that's about his economic background. About the family background, why do we let it to Encik Salim?
Okay. Thank you, Encik Salim, for the introduction. Saya kutukkan sikit lah ya. Of course, persekolahan tu betul. Tempoh pekerjaan tu lebih sikit lah. Saya dalam kumpulan PNG, combine, I think is 17 years. But prior to that, dalam consultancy in corporate, I've been working since 1992. So you guess it's already 28 years lah dalam pekerjaan. Some of you have done much more than me lah. Saya anak bongsu daripada 6 adik-beradik, family of 6, 3 boys, 3 girls. Orang Selangor, lahir di Banting. So, ayah saya petani, mak saya penuri getah, petani jugalah dalam bidang pertanian. So, my early years, I will normally not see my mother sebab dia keluar menuri awal. You know, the discipline of penuri getah kan, pukul 4-5 dia dah keluar untuk tore. Saya selalu join bila nak tuang getah. Kalau kata hari cuti tak sekolah, saya akan pergi bawa timba, tuang getah tu, bawa ke tempat buat getah keping, dan lepas tu campur lah. Bercampur bagi dia getah tu, dan baru pergi dapur. Same kan? My father is harvester kat ladang kelapa sawit. So, tu pun saya ikut juga. So I can harvest all farm, no problem. Saya biasa juga angkat tandan kelapa sawit yang besar-besar tu. Saya tak pakai seluar jeans kalau you notice. I will only wear jeans bila I pergi ladang. Sebab jeans tebal. So bila saya angkat tandan kelapa sawit tu selalunya tak tembus lah. So, saya akan pakai sarung tangan dan saya akan angkat tandan letak dekat basikal. Sudah jam 5 awal tahun saya jatuh basikal. So my rhythm got distracted. So I did not get 5A. Sebab 3A 2B. Tak dengar? Okay. So I got 3A 2B. So kat situ ayah saya balik dan tegur saya. My sister dah luar. Bagi tahu kat my dad. Dia balik balik kubur. Dia kata, apa ni? Cakap jauh tapi saya kena cakap Melayu lah kan. Dia tak faham.
Kita nak dengar jauh macam
this is important where we develop characters. We must always look at how people perceive. Sometimes it's not in words. Just by expression, it's good enough. Yeah? I've been doing well in terms of education. Bila dapat 3A, 2B itu sebenarnya it's a disappointment. So my dad doesn't say anything. Dia bunyi. Itu je. I duduk kat luar, lepas tu yang masuk dalam yang nangis. Because I know he's not happy. But that is the energy that I use to apa ni, motivate myself. Motivate in a sense that I know the expectation that he wants is for me to excel in studies. Dia tak minta apa-apa. Dia nak tu. English become the medium of language. Saya sekolah kampung. Anian pun yang sebut union. Yeah. Then you have to be in this kind of environment where everybody converse in English. And kita budak kampung. Raja bawa sebulan RM20. Yeah. I have friends who come to school bawa RM50 sehari. English literature is the class where I normally kena berdiri atas kursi ataupun duduk luar kelas. Sebab baca entah apa-apa. Aku Monte Cristo. English literature. Apa dia cakap ni? Bahasa peninggala kan? Okey lah. Kena berdiri dekat sama berdiri atas kursi ataupun duduk luar kelas. Sebab tak dapat baca dengan betul. So what do? I practice. Setiap hari saya baca surat bahasa Inggeris. Since then, even masa cuti pun, saya akan make sure surat bahasa Inggeris datang ke rumah. Kenapa? Sebab saya nak practice. Supaya saya boleh mainkan bahasa Inggeris. Belajar tingkatan 2, apart from English, I've improved. Ada subjek pun naik excel, alhamdulillah. Saya dapat masuk elite class. Class C. Sebab A, B, industrial art, C is commerce. I'm from commerce stream, masuk C. Di ITM, saya student leader. Untuk Estate Management Association, saya become president 3 kali. Masa dekat Manjung, and then 2 kali dekat Syarikat. Sebenarnya cita-cita saya nak jadi pilot.
Okay.
Tapi my mum is, dia tak bagi. She's very much against it. So itu penting restu mak bapak. Dulu kita minta restu, sekarang kita bagi restu ke anak. So kena make sure kita jangan apa ni, kena soal sendiri lah kenapa suka kan. Kenapa saya nak jadi pilot? Saya suka terbang sana sini, jalan-jalan. And of course, asalnya cita-cita jadi polis dengan askar.
Standard.
Tanya kata cita-cita masa belajar 1, 2, 3, polis, askar.
Saya polis.
Cikgu.
Cikgu, bomba.
But basically kerja tetap lah. Kan? So, but kenapa saya nak jadi pilot? Because saya suka terbang. Saya beritahu my mum, mak, kalau saya pergi London ni, saya ambil pinjaman mak. You know, by then saya dah tahu maths kan. Dah buatlah kira-kira. Kalau grad ni nanti, aku berhutang banyak ni, mana nak bayar ni. Yes, I know I can do well, but most probably, I was expecting 75% apa tu, waiver lah. You still have to pay 25%. So, on that score, 2 of us, saya dengan my friend pergi. Dia nak banker. So, keluarga berada lah, okey lah. Saya anak kapuk. Dia kata, ya memang saya stay lah. Saya sambung dekat Malaysia. Masa saya buat diploma tu, ada practical 6 bulan. So, masa tu, the perception of ITM, English tak bagus. Yeah? That is a general perception. It's not the reality. Yeah? My batch was the first one yang go into private practice and a lot of us excel. Few of us dekat Jones Lang, saya masuk Ryan and Co. C.H. William, ada couple of person. Semua got good review. We can converse in English, we can do good report writing. We can do a lot of analysis. That's where eventually lepas tu senang bagi student ITM masuk private training. Evaluation code. Kalau tak, semua pergi JPPH. Sam, you know? JPPH. The other thing about JPPH, JPPH dapat duit lah. Tak ada. Dekat private practice dapat duit. Bukan banyak pun. RM150. Mula-mula. Lepas tu dapat RM500. Okay. A lot.
Sebab masa tu, RM500 banyak tu.
RM500 sewa umat. Dapat 120 seorang. So, okey lah, ada lebih sikit ke. Tahun 96, baru 4 tahun bekerja kan? Pada 92 kan? That's my first position where I was appointed sebagai assistant manager. Yeah. Tapi that rank, I have to manage companies. Yeah.
As an assistant manager, in business focus.
And at that time, the boss tu Amin Shah is a high flyer lah. And at that time memang dia ambil as part of the so-called panel of 50 global CEOs. Saya bekerja di Wing Building dekat dengan sekolah saya, Jalan Bukit Nanas. Kalau dulu orang KL dia tahu Wing Tuition, bawah Wing Tutorial kan. Dan lepas tu saya masuk corporate lah. Year 2000 is where I join PNB Group dekat Golden Hope. Lepas tu masuk Gatri. Lepas tu jadi Sam Darby. Then masuk PNB.
So it's all within the PNB Group of companies.
Yeah. So there's total combined 19 years. Kita tak ada peluang. Macam saya cerita ni, tak semua orang dapat. Kita kena ada basic understanding of property. Alhamdulillah, I have my background. So, macam Jenai Alam dulu pun. Ada satu encounter, I have an engineer who came to me cakap, Cik Salim, we need to review the design for the engineering. Because the basic principle yang biasa kita apply is, bila tengok township, kalau boleh kita buat balance cut and fill. Bila balance cut and fill, dalam a lot of the situation, you akan dapat tanah tu asal macam ni akan jadi macam ni. Dia potong yang tinggi, tambun dekat yang rendah, tanah jadi flat. Ya, kat mana premium value nya kalau tanah flat? Dia keluar tengok rumah, nampak rumah orang. Imagine kalau kata kita buat bangunan ni dekat situ, tinggal-tinggal ya, semua dapat view kan, macam kat stadium. Semua dapat view kan? Dengan alam macam tu. Engineer datang, kata tak boleh buat balance cut and fill sebab encounter rock. I can just do the simple decision. Hey, kena continue lah. Maksud lah tak boleh buat. Tak boleh buat, change the contractor lah. Tak, tak, tak buat macam tu. I just bagi imaginary reason. So what I did is, I cakap dengan the engineer, okay, jom kita pergi site. So I went to site. I tengok the current physical form, I tengok drawing macam mana dia nak buat. So I stand at the side, I tengok the contour now is gradual, cantik. Then I tanya kenapa nak potong. So I cakap dengan dia, it's not about the engineering solution, it's about the value. If I have views, I can sell premium. Yeah? If I don't have views, can I sell house? So because of that, I kata okay, I look at the map, ada satu kawasan which is open area. I kata okay, let's do this. Dekat open area ni, kita buat macam mencutan the viewing platform. Sebab bila you naik about 2-3 stories daripada sini pun, you akan dapat view of KL skyline daripada Jenai Alam. So that solution, had we continued with the engineering punya request, I would have to pay more sebab it requires excavation in rock. You know, kalau kata rate, excavation biasa RM3 atau RM3, kan? Excavation in rock, RM20 lah. And in that process, I dijimatkan RM5 dari segi infrastructure. So from project perspective, it gives me the premium because now I have a gradual slope. I can do premium products. And on top of that, I jimatkan dari segi cost to excavation, the earthwork. So infra cost jimat. Project masa saya ambil ada 19%. Lepas saya buat review, dapat more than 50%. Yeah. So kita kena continue buat benda macam ni. It's a continuous process. Tak ada jalan singkat. Bila saya throw challenges, why we have to do IDS? Because we need to somehow create a mechanism, how can we shorten construction period. Kalau kita kata cakap 42 tingkat, 44 tingkat susah, orang lain boleh buat 118. Sekarang dah sampai 115 lah. Lagi 3 tingkat je, dia punya core tu dah siap.
Some of the key takeaway during the last 1 minute that I managed to capture. First,
remember, you are bigger than the problems. Okay, always stay positive. Negative vibes is just a music. And take it, it's just a part of the communication when you grow. And always stay focused. And always move forward. And don't waste time handling the past, because you're going to change the past. And must always understand the need of the customer. Before you make anything, understand what the customer needs. And also remember, celebrate success no matter how small it is. Okay? There's some other key things that was selected, was shared by JSLM. And on behalf of the committee, the organizer, and colleagues, thank you very much, JSLM, for sharing your available times. We really appreciate it. And we hope we more sessions of this we can organize in future. In fact, for your info, we started this type of program since 2018. It started from the MD before, and after that, we gave the opportunity for our SVPs and EVPs to share as well their life and then their expression. It's part of the HR intervention to improve the communication between the leaders and the team members. Thank you, Dijisari.
Thank you for investing your time as well to listen to me. All this, I think, macam saya cakap dengan Cik Isham, it's something off the cuff. Because I don't normally share a lot of this unless it is on a live example in the situation. Yeah? And I hope you can share some of the knowledge that you learned today with your team members and provides the positive vibes. Right? Yeah. Yang baik itu pada saya daripada Allah lah. Yang salah itu saya sendiri. So, minta maaf. Satu lagi point yang tak tersebut tadi is concept of knowledge. Bila you buat kerja macam tu sahaja kan, knowledge stays with you. People cannot take it away. Yeah, take those as your life learning, lifelong learning. Yeah. You may not be able to apply it here. You may be able to do it somewhere else. Yeah? But take it as a knowledge. That's important. Yeah? Thank you very much.